You will never, ever, ever know.
Okay.
Oh, no. Oh, no. This is not good. Dad, I made this in art class especially for your birthday. Love, Lucas. Oh, this is great. This is just my luck. Oh, yeah. A Lucas original. Great, so now he can hate me more than he already does, and his dad has something else to blame on me. Perfect mother rabbit better. Jeez. All right. Okay. I'll just. Oh, come on. There's too many pieces. I don't know what this stupid thing is supposed to look like. Let's take a
minor.
I'm sorry, I must have dialed the wrong number.
Is this Caroline Benson?
Yeah, how did you know that?
Virginia Benson's calls are being forwarded here in case you called.
To a hospital? Why? What's wrong?
Your mother's had a stroke, Caroline. She's not doing well.
You mean she's dying?
If you could get here as soon as possible, it might make all the difference. Can I tell her you're coming? Hello?
Yeah, tell her daughter's on her way.
Dearest Tony, I just found out an old friend of mine from high school is very sick and might even be dying. Did I ever tell you about J.J. Carson? Well, her mother called to say she was asking to see me, so I've decided to hop a plane home ASAP. I'd never forgive myself if I didn't go, but I promise not to stay too long. I'll call you from Florida tonight. A package came for you, and I signed for it, but as soon as I took it from the delivery man, I could tell all the contents were broken. I didn't have time to put in a complaint with the company, but I will as soon as I get back. Love, Carly. P.S. Happy birthday, my love. Because of this emergency, I have to postpone the surprise dinner I planned for this evening. I've been looking forward to it for weeks, but I guess I can wait a few more days. Hope you can.
I love you. I love you, Tony. don't have time.
Oh, that's all right. It won't take long. I'm just here for a quick update on the Catherine Bell, Stefan situation.
Well, sorry. I got a plane to catch.
You don't catch anything until I say so.
I don't have any information for you, Luke. I didn't find out anything about Catherine and Stefan.
Well, then you're not trying hard enough.
Catherine doesn't trust me, Luke.
Why not?
I don't know. Probably because I'm Tony's girlfriend. Why don't you ask her?
Because I'm asking you. What makes you think she doesn't trust you?
If she is there with somebody else, they stop talking as soon as I walk in the room. And when we're alone, all she ever says to me is, how about another set of stretches?
Are you asking her questions? Are you trying to draw her out?
Come on, Luke. This is not working. Please get yourself another spy and leave me alone.
So you and my ex-brother-in-law had quite a row, didn't you?
What?
That's what this is about, isn't it? You're gonna go away, cool off, and then you can come back and have a nice, hot, juicy reunion.
You are really twisted, man.
Thank you. It's a gift.
It's not about me and Tony, okay? I have to visit a friend who's really sick.
Cut the crap, Caroline, before this gets ugly.
I'm going to see my mother, all right?
Bobbie?
Wait. Not Bobbie! Virginia Benson, my real mother. The only person who ever gave a damn whether I lived or died, and she is in the hospital and she needs me!
Okay, tell me.
She had a stroke. And she's in the hospital and she might... she might die.
God, I'm sorry. I like her.
She used to knit me these little sweaters with different colored buttons on them. You know, it was her trademark. Every morning, fresh squeezed orange juice, and then she would help me with my homework. She even used to wait for me outside my volleyball practice so that I didn't have to walk home in the dark. Now I need to thank her. I need to tell her that I love her.
I'm sorry.
Such a hard time. I mean, I mouthed off constantly. I never came home when I was supposed to. If she told me to do something, I wanted to do the opposite. Luke, if she dies before I get the chance to tell her how I feel about her, I am never going to forgive myself for the rest of my life.
Hey, pull yourself together, kid. Pull yourself together. You got a plane to catch.
Are you going to let me go?
Yeah. I can't keep you from Virginia to talk about this. She needs you.
I gotta go, okay?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna wait for Tony.
Why?
He's good company.
Yeah, he is. You know, it's funny. When I first got together with Tony, I was so happy. I thought I was gonna burst. You know, I just figured we were in love and everything else would just fall into place. It didn't happen like that, though.
It never does, baby.
That is sad, isn't it?
Don't you got a plane to catch? Dive of my career, man, right off the high dive into third base, making a goal, coming around the end, making a goal, and there you do. You come in and you just butt in, and what happens?
Wait, let's go back to the first. An in run through his cousin to accomplish what?
You've got to learn to play this thing closer to the vest. I know you can keep a secret. You kept Carly long enough.
Just get to the point. I don't like what I'm hearing, and I'm hearing nothing.
Were you the one that told me, don't tell anybody that Stefan's got a woman on the side or
not? Excuse me if I can't shrug it off. When Stefan and Catherine, they suddenly drop out of sight just when Bobby's out of town. If he hurts Bobbie as badly as I did, Bobbie may get over it, but I won't. But just when Stefan and Catherine disappear from sight, Bobby's out of town. If he hurts her as badly as I did, Bobbie may get over it, but I won't.
Hey there. Is this a private conversation or can a homesick roommate join in?
When'd you get back?
About an hour ago. I probably should have.